So we saw this function in the last section, and we talked about how we could move the tangent line around at different points. So for instance, we can find the tangent line at that particular point, and now we know that the slope of the tangent line is the value of the derivative at that point. So one of the things we did also was look at the slope value. So what happens here is at negative 1.34, the slope of the line is 3.39. We drag the point around and we watch the slope change. So we can see the values here on this point as it gets more shallow. We saw where it was 0, and we saw it decrease, become negative, we saw it become 0 again, and we saw it go very large positive as the tangent line gets more steep. What we're talking about now is the derivative as a function, because we have a unique output, the slope, for each input when we're talking about the derivative. So what we're going to do now is take a look at how the outputs change as we change the inputs. So as we drag this, look at what happens to our outputs. They start decreasing, and we have something tracing those outputs now. Then we go through here, come down and back up, and we get a rough sketch of the graph of our derivative. This is what we mean when we say the derivative is a function. It's a function whose outputs are the slopes of the original function. So here we have the graph of the derivative of the original function. So the black graph is the derivative of the red graph. Its outputs are the slopes at each input of the red graph.